Tonight is an extraordinary evening because we've come together in support of an extraordinary man, Governor Bill Clinton. I am so thrilled to be part of honoring Governor Clinton, and I am doubly thrilled to be tonight's first speaker because I have an important announcement to make. It is now impossible for George Bush to win the election in November. I know, a lot of pollsters and political experts have been working on this for a long time, but I have figured out that George Bush cannot possibly get enough votes. How did I do it? Simple mathematics. First, I eliminated all women because he's just bashed us left and right. That's 51% of the population right there. Next, I subtracted single parents, of course. I also subtracted any parents who care about education, the environment, daycare, health care, family leave, you know, the future of the country. Then I subtracted the 9 million gay voters he's been bashing. Obviously, people who want choice and personal freedom aren't voting for Bush. Then I subtracted artists, teachers, and all periodontists. They hate Bush. I can't explain it. Anyway, so when the math is all done, there's maybe like 8,000-10,000 people left who might vote for Bush, which is a respectable showing. And there's a lesson in this for you, Mr. Bush. It's a very basic rule of presidential politics. See, you don't bash the citizens of the country that you're actually running in.
Either by word or by deed. Because what's done to them, they will do to society. They learn by example. Bigoted parents create bigoted children, who in turn become bigoted parents themselves. But if we educate them properly and give them the love and respect that they deserve, we as a nation will be enriched. They are our future, and they are our hope. And we hold tomorrow in our hands when we hold our children in our arms. Careful the things you say, children will listen. Children will look to you for which way to turn.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I have been embarrassed by a lot of people, but never so well as Barbara did tonight.
...of this evening in support of the Clinton-Gore ticket. I'm proud to be a lot of things. I'm proud to be the L word. I looked up the word liberal in Webster's dictionary and encyclopedia. Here's how it's defined. Liberal, from the something I said. Hey, where you going? From the French libère, meaning free. Not narrow or contracted in mind, broad-minded. Do you have to have the lights on here? The audience? Free from prejudice, independent in opinion. That's nice. I'm also proud to be the F word. In the same dictionary, a feminist is an advocate of social and political freedom for women, with rights and opportunities equal to those of men. And I'm equally proud to be a member of the Hollywood artistic community, many of whom I've shared the stage with tonight, and so many of you in the audience. Throughout history, artists have always been the communicators, giving voice to the dreams and frustrations of the people. They are often the conscience of society. So yes, I'm proud to be a liberal, feminist, American artist.
While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair as we raise our voices in a solemn prayer. God bless America.
Join me on the stage, and we can sing that all together.